So today's goal is to approve the mortgage of Frankie Hudson Okay. So this is a double object, the simple version, as you want to have. This is the stronger version. So double object, simple, double the Russian and the system, the system of finally, if this immediately satisfy this condition. And so in this case, a central charge is given by this formula. And if you apply this formula for SL2 case, you get this central charge. And this is exactly the Amin-Hall series. And actually, this theorem holds for any simple D algebra, where also you have to modify some numerical data. For example, this has to be run for T. But still the rationality and unsuitable finite is still poor. So this gives a huge generalization of the universal impact. So to prove this, I use the result I explained last time. And to use this, I need to study admissible Kampani graphics. So what is admissible representation? So great. So I'm now I'm not using GLN about this system. And we have the character. And our way is called admissible. So lambda is greater than. This means that the row shift of weight is this regard. So this is not. We are root of T. And the second function is the Q span of the integral root system is Q, the same as Q span of the real root system. Where this is so called the integral. Is a set of PR group whose pairing with lambda is this is a summer root system. In the set of PR roots. And in this case, so you reduce the highest level representation with highest lambda is called admissible. This is reducible highest weight representation of T.
So what is delta hat k?
Red.
Yeah. Delta hat what?
Delta hat real.
Real.
Ah, real.
And is it true that
this theory have the real phenomena. It's the real roots of some another A5 idea, actually. Another A5 idea, actually.
For
the
Serbian, it's isomorphic to the system.
But another.
For other cases, it can be product.
Oh, product. Same rank. But total rank is
and if you take an element here, so what this means? So what this means that the corresponding polynomial state polynomial is true. So we have the wild cat type character. Just as in the case of an integral representation, although
the difference is e to the one side.
So also this is not the whole core of my white blue, but this is a subgroup generated by the regression corresponding. If I start for type A, so this is isomorphic to the affine one of ISL. So under this condition, actually, for type A, this means isomorphic to the set of real roots. So this is a subroot system, but because it's an infinite system, it can be isomorphic. And the corresponding wild root is isomorphic.
So did you forget some term e to the lambda on the right hand side?
Just
an action.
It's built in.
It's just an action.
So because this is isomorphic to the affine wire group, this contains a bunch of translation. So this character can be within the theta function. It has no joint invariance problem. So modify the character. Normalize the character. This is the invariant of the action. And conjecturally, the admission representation is also for representation on this point. And still this one. so this is a very interesting representation, which includes all the integral parameters. And so exercise.
Perhaps I should say that you cannot just take Q, you have to take off Z as well.
Diverge.
This could diverge because
right.
We need to
cut. So you have to consider the action of it.
What is chi of lambda?
So you have to also consider the character with respect to the character, not the only.
Yes, the character.
The whole character.
This is the character.
This is the character, yeah, so maybe I should write a few lines. It's a normalized character. It's an exercise to see if lambda and mu are admissible weight, which is different, then there's no extension. So this follows from the condition that the lambda is weak. But there's an important theorem.
But what is the change of variable? Q is e to the what? 2.8.
It is the usual.
2.8. But in the character, it is.
But Q is the usual. In the category of G. So in the category O, this is obvious, but there's no extension in the category. So the category of G.
The category of O.
The category of O is G. So this means that the category of atomistic represents form a sense, yeah, which is a finite limit. And so we are in particular interested in the case when the vacuum created. So Tartan is a Tartan. So we had a Tartan in SU.
Yeah.
And the standard Tartan subalgebra is given by this. And it's a dual. It's given. So it is a standard notation. The dual of K is denoted by lambda 0. So the vacuum weight is given by this. This is admissible. This is admissible. So this weight is admissible. If and only if K lambda 0 is regular dominant and Q is rational number. And this is the same as this condition, which looks similar to the condition. I'm using now, anyway, the fact that G is this. So this condition is almost the same as this function, except that here a cube also has to be equal to 4.
This way, I think you have to add CD with an angle 0. You won't have convergence of color, then you don't have power.
So, if you want to consider the characters, we have to consider extended, but on some other people. To think of a highest level representation, so if you think this way, we are infinite because of
But when you talk about characters,
when we talk about characters, we talk about constants. Yeah.
Also, I guess you mean that P and Q are co-prime,
equal to.
So in this case, if this condition is satisfied, P is for admissible numbers.
For your extension is for G hat.
G hat. There are two important conjectures concerning TNG was a universal affine body subject. And the simple quotient, simple affine body size of the under. And we call this atomistic affine vertex algebra in case. And so the conjecture, one conjecture is to say, so the conjecture says, so suppose that the K is not critical, then K is atomistic. If and only if associated variety of the simple vertex algebra is contained in the neighborhood. So this was the speculum of R of the AG was this is true. So this was true for SF2 by Fagan and Mack. So this should give a geometric characterization.
And so this is still a conjecture?
One direction is true.
that's what I found. But the other direction is so this is the conjecture says so if K is admissible. Then you use the finite representation of level K is a application module. Module of a simple affine vertex algebra. If and only if lambda if and only if lambda is admissible. So because the category of admissible representation form a semi-simple category. So this means that if M is a finitely generated 3KG module.
Do we have, in the second example, do we have actual admission on the right hand side? I mean, the root system is the same as.
So for the equals the same, the conjecture is simplified.
Oh, okay, you are talking about the message.
So for generally, the root system of the SOS model.
This is all for so and this.
So if M is a finite generated root KG module, on which Cartan acts locally in the port entropy. And in hat, so,
you mean locally finite?
Locally, so yes. Locally finite. In hat plus hat locally nilpotentially, then M is a direct sum of irreducible, admissible. Highest rate representation of level. So this assures the complete reducibility in this smaller category, beside the whole particular. Now this conjecture. So this is so in the case of k is a non-negative integer, so this is just an integral of my body. So this was proved by Frankel and Zhu. And for G equals S2, this was proved by Adamovich and Midas. And for SLN, for K equals minus N plus 1 over 2 where N is even was proved by Hartel. Using an explicit formula.
There are some reserved for probability cases. One direction of the Eddie-Fredra conjecture holds. So if K is atomicity, then the variety is contained in the Hilbertian. And the theorem B says that the Adamich-Miller's conjecture holds. Actually, it holds for any D-algebra, although you have to change a condition. So I explain the idea of proof. So idea of proof is quite simple. It just reduce to a series of things. Or a series of factors. Which is known by and let me explain why it's possible. So inside G we have the copy of SL2, which is spun by EI and FI and HI, where there is a Chevrolet generator, where I is from 1 to minus 1. Corresponding to the simple roots. And then then we have a corresponding parabolic subalgebra generated by FI and the upper border subalgebra, which we composed as a direction of Debye and the radical. So Debye is a direction of S to I and the sum of S to I and Kalman subalgebra, and in Y is bound by those social so this is a baby and this is the but this is A1. This is A1.
G alpha or G alpha I?
So
in the definition of M I.
Yeah.
G alpha.
Oh, sorry. G alpha. So we have the corresponding embedding in inside the G hat. Maybe I just write this anyway.
However, if you look at the so standard technique, one way to reduce to this in two case is consider restriction factor to this circle. So this does not preserve our speed. Now this is obvious if you look at the condition of the area. So you cannot just use a standard restriction. So instead I use some exotic restriction factor, which I call a semi-infinite restriction. There's a standard fact that if M is a G module, then if you consider the algebra homology with respect to M, then here there's a natural action of Davis Sadler. And also, if you consider homology, you have a natural action of Davis Sadler. And you have the corresponding construction for the affine section using a semi-infinite. And so I consider the semi-infinite homology with respect to this infodent. So if M is a G homology, you can define semi-infinite cohomology with respect to M. In a similar way as the BRSD complex associated with so-called reduction. So this is a cohomology. So the complex is just exactly the same. The tensor with a fermionic fourth space associated with M. So we were using a fermionic Fock space associated with M, but this time we take a fermionic Fock space associated with M, which has number of generators that is the same as the dimension. And we take a similar differential operator. And here, this is to hat I act. In fact, if the level is K, then this becomes a level KI, where KI plus 2 equals K plus 2. So the fact is the on this cohomology space, this is to hat I act with a level KI.
Was it even K plus N?
K plus N, yeah.
N.
So maybe I should state in more precise way.
N, just like SLN.
SLN, N of SLN. So this is, in general, this is a dual constant. So that's the precise statement of what I said, that there is a vertex algebra homomorphism from affine algebra associated with SL2 at level KI to this semi-infinite homomorphism. So which sends AXG to the
similar formula. So if you consider I something like that, this map exists as a level of complex, and so this because this commutator is different, so this can be seen as
the first term, the x loop of z times
so this is a homology of the complex so of this form. And so xg acts here. And you see I is a generator corresponding to the basis of the name. Now this is and so if you look at this formula, you find that if t is so the summation means that if k is admissible for g hat, then ki is admissible. So because of the shift of level by Coxeter numbers, so this kind of thing. So if you can hold that the atomicity is preserved by semi, so this this a semi-infinite restriction, preserved by semi-infinite restriction. And indeed, this is the case. So if k is admissible, then the above vertex algebra homomorphism factor C. About the right in from a simple quotient, simple affine vertex algebra associated to the height to this space of the because Ki is an admissible number for S2, but this is admissible. So if you have a module of VKG, you have to take a simple version. So here I have to take I don't need to take a simple quotient for this bit to say that. take a simple quotient, the map factors through the map matrix. So because of the factoriality of the semi-infinite restriction, you could have a module of, so this is, I forgot to say, this is a vertex algebra. And if you have a module of a VKG, and the corresponding semi-infinite restriction is a module of a vertex algebra. And hence module of a disk, which is a disk. So you can use results obtained by the matrix on the representation theory of affine vertex algebra to deduce some condition from this, some information for a module to be a module of a VKG. So,
and what's the proof of this?
So,
will you explain the proof?
Yeah, it's an extra sign. It's not trivial, but I don't think I have time to.
So it's not an exercise for some people, but it's not easy at all. So you have to construct semi-infinite BGG resolution.
I had to use I first construct the need to be the distribution, and then I will take it. You can find the proof. So from this we get, so I don't have time to explain in the detail, get enough information to prove Albert Miller's computer. Maybe I should take a number.
So I
now make a comment on the proof of taking Franklin conjecture.
Proof of what?
Proof of this distribution. So maybe I start with spinning by circuits. So you have an exact sequence. So this is the maximum subject. And it is known by Katz and Wakimoto that this is generated by a synchrony, by one synchrony. And if you take Zuse C2 algebra module formula, so because this is a writing, so you have so that in powers in C2 again. You have this exact sequence. And this was R of the KT, which is the function. And this is a closing response. So this is due to situation associated with the second of my bonus. So this is a quotient by the integer of lambda. So I care to use the integer of n point. And this is a projection formula for the singular vector there are some formula for singular vectors. And this implies that the image of we give of the singular vector in IK is non-zero. So it is to see the image is non-zero. And so which generates? Which is because it's coming from singular vector, it's annihilated by the adjoint taxon, which is it is a singular vector with respect to adjoint action of G equals this. And the constant, so the separation theorem, and says such a vector is a multiple of the vector of the form of this source. It's a multiple of some power of omega and some times some multiple of power of E, where omega is the generator of the Euclidean.
Now it's an exercise. Lambda is an element in the variety.
So n is from SLM. What about n?
No.
Just ij. But can it be a linear combination or something?
No.
Yes, probably.
Because it's a homogeneous.
But it's not known what these exponents are, R and S.
You can determine. You can.
Oh, they are explicit.
It is determined by the weight of the big one. But we don't need it. So this what is this variety? So this is a zero set of zero row person of right, which contains which is some constant times omega R is which is so GT invariant. And it's an exercise to see so the element here has to be zero of this polynomial. Maybe I should so let x be a so lambda be an element of in this zero row class. And want to show if we do, lambda is an element of this variety, point in this variety, and want to show so this is the element of the nilpotent point, which is a zero set of zero row class of omega. So we want to show that if there's an element here, it has to be a zero. And suppose that
why n is in zero locus?
Because it's just says it. It's just one in my
suppose that so omega lambda is non-zero. Then because this has to be killed by this element, E lambda has to be zero. The pairing with E is zero. But since this is G invariant and omega is G invariant, the G E lambda equals to zero for all elements from the E. So this implies that the lambda equals to zero and we get convergence. So this proves a case for this. This is an exercise. For general G,
So we again use the semi-infinite restriction function.
So I just explain the algebra.
Take up rate.
So we have the vertex algebra embedding from here to this semi cohomology, which is a cohomology of certain complex. Where C is VKB tensor.
I think so. It's MI.
So in left hand is SLI. In left hand is R.
Right.
Yes.
Right. This is two.
Ah, it's in 2I.
So this induces a map between.
So C is BK of G tensor what?
Sorry,
F.
Tensor? Ah, that's an F.
Yeah. So
FMI, I suppose.
So this induces some Poisson algebra homomorphism between corresponding Poisson algebras. And here, we know for the SL2 case, omega I is important. So omega I is the omega I, omega for SL2. So here, omega I is also important because this is algebra. And so if you look at this definition, and you don't have time to explain, you find that the HI of some power is zero modulo in this ring modulo n minus plus n plus it's a low one reported on this.
And minus plus.
N plus. So this is
N is contained. n is a sub-variety.
Sub-variety.
Ah, sub-variety of G.
If the intersection term of the kappa is zero, then it means this one thing.
Ah, yes, yes.
Yeah,
it's
this I got, you know, quite good. It's a exercise for this
period. Yes, it's a nice idea.
So is this true?
So I take over.
So
I use the result I explained for the Michigan representation to prove the bracket cuts working. So let me start with the this technique. So theorem or corollary of the one prediction of the Higgins-Mendel conjecture is that if K is admissible, suppose that the image of a simple affine, simple admissible affine vertex algebra is non-zero, then this vertex algebra, which is a quotient of W algebra, is decent. What's it to do? As I explained in the previous lecture, the non-zero condition is equivalent to that variety contained in the impotent. Contains the impotent. But as I have just proved, this is one other direction. So the variety is exactly an important point. So this implies that the variety of the image, which is an intersection of important components slices, consists of one point. So massive. And so this proves that finite dimension is 6.
And
the section is the set of the companion.
So
variety of the image. The variety itself is. So I use this.
Now you move to double up.
Right, yeah.
You move to the proof of the.
So this proves. This property. So the question is when this is zero.
And of course this can be understood if you want can compute the character. Actually, this has been already computed apparently back to Akimoto by assuming the vanishing of the cohomology, which proves to be called now. So this follows from cohomology vanishing. So, and the Euler one by principle and you won't cut that. So using this information, you can compute the character of the unit and see when it is non-zero problem. And the result is that this image, so if K is atomicity, K is an admissible and Q is a denominator of K, which I take to be non-negative integer, then this is non-zero. I found only if Q is equal or greater than K. And this is exactly the condition, excellent condition. So in this case, this is a reset. So that's simple condition. Because this is a cosine, non-zero cosine. This is a part of the primitive patchwork picture. If K is atomicity, the denominator is equal or greater than N, then it's a simple quotient is isomorphic to the image of the simple affine particle. So this is alien.
I explain the proof if I have data.
Now I want to prove rationality. So in order to prove rationality, we need to study.
What does this mean? Because this wasn't the definition of rationality.
Now this is a simple quotient.
It's a quotient.
But this is just an image. So this is the statement of the reducibility.
Ah, because that will applicate, because the H0 will be applicable.
Yeah.
So it's the same statement.
So to study rationality, we need to study two zero. So we have this first proof of semi-simplicity. Which is of course, the algebra of the simple quotient is a quotient of the universal double, which was isomorphic to the center of the algebra. So it's a commutative algebra. So it's enough to show that the action of the center here admits central term. And because this is the algebra of H0 of VKG, which is isomorphic to it is zero of Zuse algebra of affine vertex algebra. If this Zuse algebra admits central character, then this admits central character. So we need to, we just have to study Zuse algebra about this. So if K is admissible, the first statement is that the center acts locally, finitely, on Zuse algebra of admissible vertex, which is a concept of UG. Because the Zuse algebra of universal affine vertex algebra is asking. So this is because you have the surjection from Zuse sheets algebra to the associated vertex. And so and the variety, so the variety of the algebra is contained in the associated variety of U, which is G, which is contained in the liquid. So this means that the positive part of the center invariant polynomial acts nilpotently on associated gradient of Zuse algebra. And it's an exercise to show this implies that should occur in as a top part of the dimension. So this is because otherwise we get we can get non-trivial extension of admissible representation by induction. So by induction you obtain
a representation of affine, simple affine vector sizable, and if the which is the extension, which the extension is coming from the extension of this result. But because of the complete reducibility of this stuff.
The theorem is that if K is admissible, then the Zuse algebra of simple affine vacuum algebra admits the center theorem and so is a Zuse algebra over W.
So does.
So does.
So you can work. So this Zuse algebra is isomorphic to the quotient of UG, where JK is the image of Zuse algebra, of Zuse bimodule of maximal submodule inside Zuse algebra of G, which is a sum. And I define M to be quotient of this Zuse algebra by left ideal generated by n plus, which is isomorphic to UG. And this is going to be a left module of the world. So on this left UG module n plus at locally and important by construction. And the center at locally by nine because of the previous proposition. So this one, this together implies that Cartan acts locally, finite. And it's an exercise to show these two conditions means Cartan is locally. So then there is a direct sum. Irreducible highest weight representation of UG. Hence, other means, center here. The center acts by the corresponding center here. reason is if you take an element from the center, this decomposes the existing distinct element in such that this product is a zero modulo this idea. So this can be written A plus N for some A in A K and N omega B omega X U and W U in J K and W in U G. Adjoint action of UG is sensitive. So as an add G module, this decomposes into a direct sum. So we can take a projection to UG0, which is isomorphic to trivial representation as a representation with respect to adjoint action, which is just the same. So this element, because this element belongs to the center, it's the same as projection because projection is linear. It decomposes as this, and this is a zero because of the Harshander. And this is an element of, so because this belongs to JK because this is RG. So this means the Zuzalita. So now I want to prove the rationality into the semi-simplicity. So for this I need to classify a simple WKG for admission. For K satisfying this. So because the algebra of the universal one is isomorphic to the center, the simple module of the universal W algebra is parameterized by a center curve.
By this theory.
Which can be written as a posset of
dual of kappa.
So here we have the two lambda, which correspond to the evaluation of the AVG. And I denote corresponding a simple module by theta. And I want to know which P lambda is a module of the simple. So, because this algebra of a simple affine vertex algebra admits central character. This decomposes into a corresponding component where this is so by applying a reduction factor, we get a decomposition of the this algebra of that algebra.
What is in that?
Reduction. We have the factor to the category of
this will go it's a quantum thing.
Yes. I'm using notation. I'm writing the same notation. So this gives a decomposition with respect to the central character. And the criterion for this to be non-zero is that the variety, corresponding variety is so this is non-zero if and only if the variety of this quotient of UG is exactly the neighborhood. Because this algebra of so this is a quotient of UG. It's quotient by the center. It's the corresponding
component is also the quotient
of this quotient algebra.
The fact
which is well known that the variety of this quotient is exactly the nilpotent of point if and only this is isomorphic. If there's a kernel, the variety must be smaller.
What do you mean kernel computation?
It's a correspond to the classification of primitive variety. But this is a primitive variety. So there's a bifurcation between idea from quotient and submodule of monomodule. There's a corresponding between category org and Hessian variety. And if you use this function, you can see this. I'm not prepared to do this.
So, since so this classifier seems to,
and so this is before theorem, is that all primitive ideals representations in useful places.
Right.
At this case.
Yeah.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, so because this classified simple UKG module, any module of this can be induced to be a module of Adamisha algebraic algebra. It must be a Adamisha. So the only possibility is that this quotient, this isomorph occurs if that's also if this isomorphism occurs, then if and only if for weight such that p for any orbit of lambda by dot action of lambda LG, this must be MG lambda is top part
top to component
of the new plus k lambda 0 is admissible. And this isomorphism must be. So corresponding admissible representation has a Wawa motion as a top.
What do you mean by the MQ?
This is a Wawa module.
But how can it be called
a top component? So I denote by the
top component.
If this is not the reducible Wawa module, other module appear as a representation of alpha reducible, and I got it as right.
The set of non-degenerate atomistic way to be atomistic way such that any pairing with the root of G does not belong to it.
It's definition.
It's definition. Then it's easy to see double algebra absorption
while we're packed by the dot product.
It's preserved by the dot product. And so is admissible weight, then the top part is isomorphic to the Wawa module of G if and only lambda is degenerate. So altogether this classifies, this finishes the classification of the
central module of the double algebra.
So the theorem is that the symmetric case is admissible and the denominator is equal greater than n, then simple WK there's one-to-one correspondence between simple module of a simple double algebra and quotient of this set of atomistic weight by the action of the weight. And here the corresponding simple modules is exactly. And so this has been already computed by Katsun, friendly Katsun Wakimoto, and this set is isomorphic to the set of so if k plus h n is k over q as before, then this set is isomorphic to the set product of integral dominant highest weight, integral dominant weight of level t minus n times integral dominant of level q minus n divided by gn. Gn is a thinking model, which is what it is.
Symmetry of extended
limit.
extended.
And this is exact. So when you think about the Virasoro case, this is exactly the same. Which dies in the past two. Finally, prove the rationality of Gabriel's since we already know it's a disse, we have to show there's no trivial extension between simple. And explain this. So it's possible to construct this simple representation by reduction function, by modified reduction. So there's a way. So this is a part of complex control. So there's a modified reduction factor. So I talked about the factor from this category to this. But this factor is not sufficient to get all simple representations. In order to get all the simple modes, you have to extend this factor. But if we extend this factor, if we extend the factor and didn't change the definition, this does not going to be example. So you have to modify the factor. And we get a certain factor which is called a minus reduction. So the basic idea is the following. So the grading energy operator here was shifting. So it's not very compatible with the weight here. So the highest weight of Raman module, so the embedding diagram, the order of Raman module might be changed because of the shift of the. So we need to somehow twist the action of the degree to get to compatible with the gradient. By automorphism or by translation. maybe I don't have time to explain, but you can find how to set a factor in the paper of Frankie Kantonoto or my paper in 2009. And you obtain a certain factor which is compatible. Which is actually easy to define. You just replace n minus, or n plus and n minus, and change the definition slightly. But this definition makes a big difference. And so because I don't have time, I just explain the result quickly. Which enjoys the following group. So the theorem
is that it? So this minus reduction factor, so enjoys vanishing category for all objects of category all objects.
So this factor is exact.
And if you look at the image of a Bahamut, this is isomorphic to Bahamut. So this is a Bahamut of double algebra with IC3 lambda.
So this is just an induction from the one-dimensional representation of the center. So is there the usual way to do induction in vertex algebra theory? I don't have time to explain, but you can keep that.
In particular, this is a simple character formula. The character formula is just some number, and eta function to rank of. So in the case of Virasoro, this is the Bahamut. And the third statement is the image of a simple module. This can be zero. And but if it's not zero, this is isomorphic corresponding simple module. And if this happens if and only lambda is lambda bar is anti-total. Which means that the top part is isomorphic to Bahamut.
So in this way, we get all the irreducible bisect representation of Bahamut.
The important corollary is that because of the exactness, it induces a map between characters. So if you have if characters of Bahamut is written by, of course this is written by certain adjunctive polynomials, then you can send. So if lambda bar is anti-dominant, then you can send, you can apply this functor and it commutes this character. So then we get a character of a simple completely the composition factor of Bahamut. So in particular, it's easy to see the following assumption. The corollary is a big lambda is dominant and lambda bar is dominant, anti-dominant. So dominant as a weight of of G hat, and this is a weight as a weight of G.
What's the result in it? It's a lambda dominant.
For example, non-degenerate admissibility.
which are most dominant.
Then if it is simple, corresponding simple, most of appear in the composition factor of the gamma module, then it has to appear in the top part. This have to sit in the top. This is what the problem usually. And so from this we can see that the so we can now prove that there is no extension between so if lambda mu is non-degenerate at a miscible rate, which is both dominant as a weight of G and anti-dominant as a weight of G, there is no extension. So maybe I should make this as an exercise. Maybe I just repeat the thing. So we want to show that if there's an exact sequence, this must be speed. This must be speed. And we have the corresponding highest weight vector. And this is highest weight vector and the corresponding conformal weight. Corresponding conformal weight. And so I take up a pre-image, homogeneous pre-image. So if delta, if this is greater than this, then P again V is a singular vector. So there is a map from gamma module to N, which sends P lambda to V. But P nu does not occur in this gamma module, in the composition factor of gamma module, because of this model. No two distinct synchronization occurred in the gamma module. So image H equal to P lambda, so it's speed. And if the order is opposite, can take. Then we can apply the duality function. And transpose the
than exact series and radius series.
And the weight is the same, then the same simplicity of those algebra.
I incorrect.
So if F is not principal important, then of course many things don't work. For example, is there also minus functor and plus
functor? If there actually is, but I don't know whether we can get all simplicities. But semi-simplicity of those are the best. It should be true that the old simple module of the Earth, but this is not clear in the level of the finite numbers.
But I suppose you know that this term that gives us the algebra is semi-simple, and see two conditions of holds, then we have to turn to the regularity of the
it's a conjecture. I mean,
but what my student observed?
So Van Eekelen observed that this semi-simplicity of those algebra and the finance implies measure invariance.
Ah.
Trace functions.
So the problem of regularity still remains.
So, as a last speaker, I'd like to ask you to find